title is shown here, but originally, at the beginning, I just want to talk on candle reactor at this place. But a member of the human collective just asked me to talk more wide area. Probably because this is the last chance for me to talk or this kind of things in a series, because as professor of Tokyo Tech. And so I just try to make a presentation more wide area. But it's very difficult for Minasan to talk on many areas. So I just want to talk on some topics which relate to big news in the innovative nuclear energy systems. From my hearing, the recent three big news in the innovative nuclear energy system, these three, one is Bill Gates is supporting traveling wave reactor project promoted by TerraPower. And Russian government has confirmed development programs of 100 megawatt LV cooled fast reactor, SVVR, which you know Professor Toshinsky is promoting, to be built by 2015, and lead cooled 300 megawatt rest by 2020. And new big researches on thorium reactors have been studied in several countries. And even in INET3, several participants, or many participants, just talk on thorium reactors. Okay, and so I choose these three titles. I begin my talk from Future Nuclear Equilibrium Society. In this study, I just investigate this kind of systems. And it include reactors, reactor and separation facility and storage facility and so on. If we investigate equilibrium state, it's just a steady state, then the equation becomes very, very simple. And we can investigate many kind of system in very short time. And so this is one example. This is view graph, this view graph shows feasible region of breeding and safety for light water cooled thorium breeder. It's a thorium breeder, and this inside of this triangle just satisfied the whole requirements, breeding and criticality and negative void collision. If you have some design which works good, then probably I'm sure the design parameter just located inside this triangle. Okay. And originally we studied for this nuclear equilibrium system in more general study. And in that study, we always consider the necessity and sufficient requirements for nuclear reactors. Inherent to solve the problems. Inherent problem with concerned energy ups. Ups. is a, just a general problem, but the nuclear energy has an inherent problem relating such as bombs and radioactive materials produced in a nuclear reactor. And this radioactive materials becomes a problem during operation as accident. And after operation, it becomes waste becomes important. So in this study, we consider five problems or five requirements: cost, resource, bomb, accident, and waste. Oh, this is just the structure of the crimes, and we investigate to find the solution for these problems. Next, a small long-life reactor. Nowadays we use nuclear reactors, but all of them, percentage of share are still not so big. And if we want to increase the share, we should diversify the sites and diversify needs, and maybe exportation becomes a key issue. And to satisfy these requirements, sites, needs, and exportation, small long-life reactor is very attractive. We can easily build in a small site, or we can use it for the district heat or desalination, so such case. And for that case, small long-life reactor is good, but small means we need more neutrons. Neutron leak becomes severe. And long life also means more neutrons are absorbed. These requirements just requires more neutrons. So, in such a reactor, neutron economy is important. And the first reactor is good for neutron economy. So how about the coolant? For coolant, large mass number is good to make hard spectrum. And also, for fast reactors, small inelastic scattering is very important. And for small reactor, as I mentioned, neutron leak becomes very severe problems. And so, for large scattering cross-section is important. If scattering cross-section is large, then the neutron just scattered back to the core before leak. So, at this stage, we can say the coolant which satisfy these requirements are good. Then I can name lead bismuth eutectic and lead and lead 208. And LBL lead and lead 8 cool small fast reactor are investigated in a group. This is one example. This is just an old design, but this is most deeply investigated design. So I just want to show this design. And this design can be shipped, can be transported by ship. So at that time, scenario is just like this. At that time, Professor Zaki is still the students in our institute. So we just design this kind of small reactor, small long arc reactor produced in Japan and operated in Indonesia. And so it's built in Japan and shipped to Indonesia and operated there. And after finish operation, then we replace by new reactor and old reactor just bring back to Japan. Just our plan for the, our original Mumbai reactor. The last topic is candle reactor. In a conventional reactor, to operate for a long period, we input more fissile material to make K effective more than unity, and we just suppress that excess reactivity by control rods. And this is maybe early stage of such reactor, and burn-up succeed, fissile material is consumed, and so we just remove control rods to maintain the criticality of the reactor. But in a candle reactor, it's just this is very schematically coarse, and maybe most pure mathematical core is the infinite length core, and burning region just moves from top to bottom or bottom to top. And here important thing is the solid fuels are fixed in the reactor core, it's the same as conventional reactors. And we don't use any burn-up control mechanism, such as control rod or movable reflector, or so on. This is just ideal or mathematical view graph. So in actual reactors, of course, core height is limited. And fuel burning succeed, burning region just arrive the end of the core. But it's no problem. If we simply discharge the spent fuel and charge the fresh fuel, then this configuration is the same as this one. So we can continue candle burning. And I think it's better to mention more. If we apply this candle burning to our first reactor, neutron economical first reactor, we can use only natural uranium or depleted uranium as fresh fuel. And we can burn 40% of this fresh fuel. And but I mentioned 40% burner. This burner is too high from the material point of view. But if we have some good materials, candle reactor is a very good option. For a long life reactor. But today, I just want to discuss the other way, because the material problem is rather difficult. So we want to introduce debugging. Then reactor itself becomes very similar to a conventional type reactor. Okay, and for this reactor, we will discuss about our Chandu reactor for five problems. Just I show in the previous slides, resource, accident, waste, atomic bomb, and cost. At first, I want to discuss about resource. Then this view graph shows the present light water reactor operation. We just manufactured enriched uranium fuel from natural uranium. Then at that time, we also obtained depleted uranium as byproducts, or at this time, as waste. And if we operate a light water reactor for 40 years, then we have a lot of depleted uranium, as John Gilran mentioned yesterday. And if we use depleted uranium in the Chandu reactor, then we can operate more than 2,000 years. I think this scenario just solved the resource problem. Next is bombs. Chandu reactor can be operated without enrichment plant or the processing plant forever once it starts, if only natural or depleted uranium is available. So, Chandu has excellent features on physical protection and non-proliferation. Okay, next is safety. Safety discussion becomes always very complicated, and each person has each consideration for safety. But for my case, I just try to reduce these two directions. One is reducing frequency of expected instances. Present accident, especially for severe accident, just caused by personal or mistake or human error. Human error is very important. So we should reduce such kind of error. It is one important issue. And the other point we should reduce is the maximum magnitude of expected consequences. It's very important. And for reducing frequency of expected instances, Chandu reactor has this kind of very good characteristics. Reactor characteristics don't change with burning. So operation is very simple. And the reactivity control system around burning is not required. It's also operator welcome. And also the management of replacement fuel is simple. Yeah, we just add depleted uranium. And the second, how about the second one? Maximum magnitude of expected consequences. Oh, this is the first reactor. For first reactor, most severe accident is deep criticality accident at CDA. But the Chandu reactors, we don't have any control rod at the operating stage. And also, coolant is very small. So this possibility is very small, and the effect is also small. So, we can say Chandu reactor is safer than conventional reactor. How about the waste? Amount of spent fuel per produced energy becomes 10% of light. I totally accept. Because this charge here burnup is 40%. But light water reactors burnup is 4%, so 1/10, and that's so on. And also the, we don't employ the processing, so waste relating to such treatment becomes negligible. So yeah. So from this point of view, candle reactor also very good reactor. At last, a cost point. Yeah, I want to mention merit. Simple reactor, and so operation and maintenance cost is low, and the fuel cycle also simple. So low fuel cost. And but how about the power density? Cooling performance is not good because the volume of coolant is small. However, we can make radial power very flat. Some of these studies are presented in NS3. And at this moment, I confirm a candle reactor is also very promising in economical point of view. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Sekimoto. Any comments, questions?
Very nice for wonderful speech. I like your intention to make the next phase of nuclear energy. And I think I just remember why we are so excited to design for it. Small diameter of the core made wonderful load of following responses. Because without fuel, there was no requirement of power up and down because the heat conductivity is very high. So, from up to temperature was 800 degrees centigrade or so compared to oxide fuel. And we can increase the power easy by the help of small diameter. In this case, your case, neutron leakage is almost enemy. However, that case, neutron leakage by certain temperature increase, and certain temperature decrease, the density of coolant made neutron leakage change, and it gave power up and down quite quickly. Negative temperature coefficient of coolant. So we consider all no control load needed for dynamic load response. It was amazing. Just by small diameter, negative temperature neutron leakage. You said neutron leakage is almost enemy in the case of candle. However, what do you think about dynamic load following response by using lead or lead business coolant? What is the
Oh, thank you very much, Dr. Hattori. So anyway, the OS stimulates the candle study, and yeah, I really thanks OS program. And yeah, for all points, it's a very challenging results. And our reactor is also the very small Doppler effect, Doppler question. And because the spectrum is very high, so as you know, if Doppler question is small, then temperature difference between, or even for this kind of operation, if we reduce the power, then temperature of fuel decrease. It is just a very difficult problem. But if Doppler is small, even if the temperature of fuel decrease, effect is very small. And sodium is sodium and lead bismuth and lead 208. We can say sodium. Lead or lead bismuth. I think it's better than sodium. And I say a cooling performance of sodium is better, but temperature coefficient point of view, lead or lead bismuth bit better. And especially lead 208 is very good. It's very good. And but it's expensive. The reason is the inelastic scattering of lead 208 is very small, the threshold is high. And so even if we lose lead coolant, the spectrum doesn't change almost nothing. But lead is a very good neutron confinement material. So leakage increase. Spectrum doesn't change and leak increase. It means a negative temperature correction. Yeah, it's very good design, I think.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you very much for very interesting. I have one question and one question. My question is, how much time is necessary between the discharge spent fuel and charge fresh fuel? And my comment, for the analyzing the critical condition in the second last time, by the recladding process, is necessary stabilize the axial profile all isotopic. It is difficult.
Yes, and if we employ debugging, we should consider the decay of plutonium-241, and also, but at the same time, we release the fission product gas, and it's just a compensate for reactivity point of view. And so we investigate this effect, but we can, it's just manageable by temperature control or something, but it's still not so small. Yeah, it's a considerable value. And well, you mentioned the interval of the charge and discharge. And so far, we consider it as a few years, one or three. But I hope we want to extend this year from economical point of view. And the reason why we employ this kind of frequent recladding is we don't have enough data for recladding. And we have only the data from Arden West. And it is just curiously such kind of system, probably we will use some other ideas. For example, we put some third material between the cladding and pellet. Such a technique, I think, may enhance a long interval for recladding. Yeah. And for such case, we also, reactivity change becomes more severe. But we should evaluate.
Design fast reactors to